Oh, I'll let you go, Mr. T, first. Tell you what, all the Coronation Street fans are in today. Are you enjoying being in a soap
very
like
much,
that?
Very much.
I mean, what were you worried?
The first soap I've ever done in my life. And thank God it's come now. If it had come 18 years earlier, then I wouldn't have been able to do The Man Who Would Be King, Gandhi and all those other things.
That's right. I mean, were you worried in a way about locking yourself into such a regimented regime?
No, not really. Not really. We have an understanding that if, for instance, if Christopher Hampton finally makes his film of the play that I did at the National Theatre, White Chameleon, or if Farooq Dondi gets his film together, which is around me, then they'll let me off for the time and then come back again.
Very nice arrangement, too.
Nice arrangement.
Obviously, tying in with your book, I want to ask you about your upbringing in India. Now, was that a relatively affluent one?
Reasonable. Reasonable. We were not poor. My mother's family was much richer than my father's family. But because my father was a medical officer, it exposed me to Hindu schools, Muslim schools, Church of England, public schools. When I did come over to the West, it wasn't such a strange experience. Mm.
But a lot of people who go to India say that they're always struck by the contrast between the affluence and the poverty. So if your father was a health officer, were you seeing extreme poverty as well?
We were. We were. And we, in fact, my father said something very sweet. He said, if you've got one piece of chapati, find a poor person who needs it and share it in half. Give him half and you have half. And so we were always very careful about looking after the poor people around us.
And has that been, you know, more or less your philosophy since? Has that attitude stuck?
Yeah.
Yes. So then you obviously became totally and completely fascinated by radio. So where was this? In Delhi?
In Delhi. The BBC of India is called All India Radio. And my first job was with them. And that I loved very much because, you see, on radio you can be anything. And, I mean, last year, for instance, the BBC World Service put out my reading of A Suitable Boy by Vikram Seth. Now, it's a 1,400-page novel, and there are 86 characters in it.
Wow.
Women, children, old men, everything like that, plus the narrator. So in 4 days, I did them all.
What you did, and therefore you did 87 voices, if you think about it.
87 different voices.
It's incredible.
And I love that.
And you're saying in the book that your mother was a good mimic. So
yes,
did she teach you voices as such?
Well, yes, we learned a lot from her. Because whichever party she went to, she'd come back and she'd sort of do all the impersonations of all the people that she'd met and things like that. So I think I was very lucky to have inherited this talent for mimicry from her.
And so who do you like to mimic in your own life for fun?
Well, there was a time when I used to mimic Sir Laurence Olivier. You know. And in fact, the very first play I did with our Unity Theatre Company in Delhi, there weren't any drama schools at that time. So I used to see all of Laurence Olivier's, he was my idol, his films, and I used to listen to his recordings and things like that. And then one critic who no longer is with us, but in his intellectual magazine, he was so sweet, and he said, Saeed Jaffrey's performance as Azrael, the Angel of Death, would have been perfectly entrancing, except for the pleasantly diverting Olivier-esque overtones in his voice. And I suddenly heard myself the way I must have come across. I was 15 when I left the mountain. There everything was clean, clean as ice. And then I discovered my own style, saying I was 15 when I left the mountain. There everything was clean. Clean as ice, clean as fire, so on.
And eventually, of course, you went to the States. Now, you played a lot of parts in the States. Did you find any racial discrimination at all there when it came to getting roles?
No, darling. In fact, I'm glad I started off. I'm glad I got the Fulbright Scholarship, which got me an MA in drama from Catholic U in Washington, D.C. Because there, with my sort of English voice and English background, there was no... Professor Godbole was the first Indian part that I played there on Broadway in A Passage to India. Otherwise, it was Sir Wilfrid Robarts and Witness for the Prosecution. Yes. So, in fact, I'm so glad, in retrospect, that my stage career began, the 9.5 years that I spent in America, were terribly, terribly not good. Had I been here, there might have been a little bit of racial prejudice.
Probably a bit more stereotyped in a way.
Yes,
in terms of roles.
Yeah.
But when you had some down periods as well, because I know that you worked in Harrods in the Christmas decoration counter for a while, which I personally can't see. But there you go.
And I came back in 73, and the only thing I did on television was Black Beauty, one. And so I didn't know how to pay the rent or anything like that. Somebody said, go and sell Christmas decorations in Harrods. Now, in 72, I had been in Captain Brassbound's conversion, a Shaw play, with Ingrid Bergman, and she had been like a protective mother to me. You know, she was lovely, lovely, wonderful lady. And the thing was that then the play finished, and then I was working in Harrods, and all the other students who were working there, he said, guess who's here, guess who's here? Ingrid Bergman, Ingrid Bergman. So I would go back, go out of the thing, put my tie on and put my jacket on and things like that and start looking like a punter. And she said, oh, my darling Saeed, what are you doing? Are you buying a parrot? And I probably had 50 cents in my pocket, 50p in my pocket.
That's so funny. And people like Michael Caine, he's been very good to you. I know Michael Caine, Sean Connery.
The King, he was wonderful.
Yeah, so what did he teach you or how good was he to you on set?
He was wonderful. He said, Saeed, you've got to remember, if you're in a position of power, you got to make the whole place a family. Chap who brings your cup of tea, the cameraman, all the other people. You know, let them know them all by their first name. All right? And then the work will smile. And it's absolutely true. God bless him. He was wonderful.
You've had a very, very successful career, and it's a very interesting read, I must say, in terms of your family in India and then all the various aspects of your career.
Well, I hope people will buy this book because it's written straight from the heart with my own hand. I haven't typed it or anything.
I think you have a few million people who watch you in Coronation Street who might just want to pick it up.
But I hope so.
I know you're dashing off back up to Manchester. Yes. So thank you very much indeed for joining us.
God bless
you. Saeed Jaffrey.
And I love you, Stephen.
Thank you very much. Thank you.